Welcome to the afternoon market update from Nirmal Banga and Hiram Bhatia. Overall, seems to be a good day of trade that we have been picking up so far in today's session. Yes, there are global cues that are coming in as a support as well. If you see in terms of the early gains, we have extended those early gains in today's session. So that's something which is really interesting. And it's mainly the bulls which are holding the grip on the large trade. There are firm views coming in from the Asian markets. Pretty much if you see broader markets as well, they are trading in line with what the benchmark indices are doing. You have the Sensex, which is up almost around 1.3% in trade. Nifty, interestingly, has topped the 10,700 mark for the first time since the 9th of March. So that's interesting on that front as well, and it's up almost around 1.4%. Financials are the one which are providing some bit of support today. You have Bank Nifty, which is clearly outperforming the benchmark indices in trade. Broader markets pretty much in line with benchmark indices right now. If you see in terms of the mid-cap and the small-cap index, smart gains coming in on that front. The only sectoral loser right now on NSE is Nifty, is the Nifty Pharma Index, which is down almost 1% in trade, whereas you have the metal index, which is in smart gains, upwards of almost around 2-2.5%. Rupee is interesting today as well. The kind of gains that we saw in the early morning trade, those gains have been erased, and right now we're trading pretty much flat in that 75.5 to 76 kind of range. So that's the level that we've been watching out for with regards to where the Indian rupee goes as well. But it seems to be a good day of trade. And clearly, if you go to see, you have energy, which is seeing smart gains, basic materials, which is seeing smart gains. FMCG is slightly under pressure. Healthcare, as we mentioned, is also under pressure. Let's quickly understand the top gainers and losers. You have Hindalco, M&M, Tata Motors, Grasim Industries, as well as and IndusInd Bank. These are a few of the top gainers on Nifty 50, whereas you have ITC, Bajaj Auto, Gail, Dr. Reddy's, as well as Cipla. These are the top losers on Nifty 50. In the broader markets, if you talk about the broader markets as well, it seems to be an interesting move as well in terms of where broader markets are concerned. Let's quickly understand Reliance Industries in trade today. That stock has hit a 52-week high. So again, good moves seen on that one from Nifty 50. There are no stocks on Nifty 50 that have hit a 52-week low in today's session. Apart from that, you have Bharti Airtel, BPCL, Aisha Motors. These are a few of the other names that are in focus as well. Let's quickly understand the movers and shakers in trade today as we speak. So overall, if you see in terms of Purvankara, they're planning to launch 11 residential projects in FY21, and that's one of the reasons why we're seeing smart gains on that one. Kalpataru Power has signed an agreement to sell the Alipurduar transmission asset to Adani Transmission. So we have both the counters that are in focus. RBP Infra has backed an order. Prism Johnson has got a note to sell the stake in RQBE. Steel Strip Wigs, again on the back of an order win, is in focus from the US. Post Motors, their SCV and LCV production is pretty encouraging, and that's something which is giving some bit of support. Shalby has commenced treatment of COVID-19 patients at their multi-speciality hospital, and that's one of the reasons why we're seeing smart gains on that one. ICICI Bank is planning to raise funds. Reliance Industries, as we mentioned, is planning to increase the network with regards to our aviation fuel stations is concerned by 50%, so smart moves on that counter. ITI, interestingly, has moved up for a second consecutive session, and if you see the kind of moves, they're pretty much encouraging. National Fertilizers has seen the biggest single-day gain since May 2014, and this is on the back of the Q1 FY21 update that has come in from their end. Shobha has also snapped the 3-day losing streak post the Q1 FY21 update. Zydus Cadila has got an approval from the Mexican authority to test COVID-19 drug. And you have eClerk Services, which has approved a buyback of shares at almost 550 rupees per share. So smart moves on these counters. So these are the movers and shakers in trade today. It is a stock-specific market overall. But if you go to see, there is participation. Majority of the cylinders are firing in today's session. US markets were short on Friday, so we've not seen any impact from that front. But how the Dow futures, as well as the other futures from Wall Street, perform in today's session is something which will give us a judgment for the second part of the trading session as well. But so far, it looks pretty encouraging with the kind of moves that we have been witnessing. That's all that we have in the afternoon market update from Nirmal Banga. Thanks for watching.